us tonight on Channels TV. You ready? Let's go. Toby Adekpoju is back on the show. Toby, good to have you with us tonight.
It is. I am honored, Austin. Good to be back. Just like I told you, I missed this so much. Good to be back. Interesting weekend. You know, I saw colorful pictures from Port Harcourt in wrestling. I mean, it's a great moment for other sports in Nigeria. You know, it is our, you know, mandate here to always ensure that we had, you know, good programs also for other sports. And I was really excited what I saw from Port Harcourt. Football, really not an exciting moment, especially for us that follow the league, especially with what happened with Accra United. We thought it's going to be a brilliant week for our teams on the continent. The league is also going on good. A couple of great results over the weekend. But I think Accra United, you know, results were so shocking over the weekend. But, you know, it is football. We hope they could get a job done in Gambia.
That's right. It's football. But anything can happen. Let's see what Accra United can do in terms of turning around that result. Inyobong Monday is also on the show. He loves being here on Mondays to talk sports. Inyobong, good to have you on the show.
Good to have you also, Austin. Good to see Toby Adekpoju. It's been a while. And after the show, we'll talk about what he brought from Morocco and the like. But Austin, I'm very unhappy. The Kenyans keep coming to this country and taking thousands of dollars and going back. It's not something we should be pleased. I should be out there getting that $50,000 or the $40,000 or the $30,000. But the Lagos City Marathon was absolutely amazing. And it's great to see that something like this is happening in Africa, it's happening in Nigeria. And we've got to thank we've got to thank Access Bank and thank the Lagos State Government for making sure that this happens year in, year out. And we hope that it will get better and get to the likes of the U.S. Marathon and the Berlin Marathons and the big marathons around the world. But great stuff. It was a weekend of action and amazing, amazing stuff in the world of sports.
Amazing things happening in our world of sports. And Inyobong and other Nigerians make the same comments whenever the North African, the Kenyans come here, the guys from East Africa, they come here and then they win the long distance race. Hey, there's a structure. There's a structure. I hear people say, where are the infrastructures? What infrastructures do you need to get on the road and run? People don't even walk. Like, these guys, they just do all that and then they come here and then they win. But it's all good. For the love of the game. Yeah. Someday we'll get it right. Amazing week indeed it was for sports in Nigeria. In Port Harcourt, we were busy with the African Wrestling Championship. What a story. The Nigeria Wrestling Federation, they said they are going for 90 gold medals. They didn't get 90, but they showed everyone that if we have the right leadership in place, with the right support, wrestling can do well. Oduanyo Adekoye, look, the girls, they were amazing. Nigeria emerged overall winners. 10 Nigerian ladies in the final, 9 gold medals in your bong and 1 silver. Blessing Oyebuchi missed out of the gold, but when you have 10 finalists and they give you 9 gold medals, amazing.
Amazing, amazing, absolutely amazing. You could talk about the determination of Nigeria and particularly the girls, because they've shown greatly that even with lack of great preparation or lack of finances or encouragement, they go out there and show the Nigerian spirit. And that Nigerian spirit is the determination they've shown clearly at this tournament. We've got to say a big thank you to the River State government for hosting such an amazing competition. It wasn't a competition that I felt we're here last Monday, and some of the people involved in the planning, particularly from the Nigerian point of view, we're talking about winning 90 gold medals. I knew that was not going to happen, but the important thing is that talents have been discovered.
That's right.
The important thing is that there are youngsters who are being groomed to take over from the aging ones. That's the important thing, and it was great that we could host. And I feel once we start hosting major tournaments on the African continent, someday we should be thinking of hosting the World Wrestling tournaments and all of that. So great one for the Nigerian team. Great one to Daniel Igale. We've got to give him a lot of credit. I mean, he's an absolutely phenomenal. And just wonderful that Africa gathered in Port Harcourt.
That's right. So this is what Inyobong is trying to say, that with the right leadership, you must somehow get results. Toby, something amazing. You know, Nigerians, they love their sports and they will support their country. You need to see this hall, the Alfred Yeti Spieth. Over 3,500 persons right there to support Nigerian wrestling.
Yeah, I mean, Austin, I saw pictures. I was really impressed with the attendance. This is what we're saying. If you create a platform for other sports to develop, for athletes to compete, you know, the fans will come out and come and watch. I mean, this is huge. Over 3,000 people. I mean, the Tunisian team, we were on board together. We were coming back from Morocco. In excitement on their face, coming to Nigeria. Had an majority of them are coming to Nigeria for the very first time. They've heard a lot of stories about Nigeria. I mean, We've talked about facility. We've shown that we had facilities where we can cap, you know, wrestlers, where wrestlers, you know, can have training and also go outside and compete. And this is a big platform for athletes, you know, to come. Like I said, we got 10 finals from the female, you know, event. I won 9 gold medals, 1 silver. I mean, it's really, really, really awesome.
Mercy and Genesis, for instance, just Mercy Genesis, as she fought in the 50 kg category in Yobong, she needed just 1 minute. Technical superiority.
Amazing.
To see off her opponent from Algeria. The Algerians are also good in freestyle wrestling. You know, Mercy Genesis will be monitoring her career, and we say she needs more of this sort of competition. Next up for Anna is the Commonwealth Games. She has dominated Africa. She needs to go to the Commonwealth Games, do well. And she's also a student of River State University of Science and Technology. So education, she is winning. On the mat, she's also winning.
One minute, Austin, and I mean, to be on the lighter note, you want to talk about the fact that that's when the likes of Akpu and Plantain came into play, because you look at the Nigerian girls and you know that they were fit. They came out there with the right training, right, the hard work was there. You could see that they didn't just want to waste time on the court. Go in there, do the job, and then finish it up. So great stuff. And to talk about Genesis like that is also great, because this is someone who's also going to school. This is someone who wants to make a name for herself, it's through education, through sports. But it's wonderful that she's been able to combine both of them. The balance is there. When you see someone like this, you know that she's just meant for the top. The Commonwealth, the world will see her.
That's right. Let's talk about someone. Nyobong mentioned Akpu and all of the soups right here. But when you look at this lady, you ask, does she take any form of Akpu? But she's such an amazing wrestler. Oduanyo Adekoye, what a story she's having with wrestling in Nigeria. She won her fourth African title, and it was so easy against her Cameroonian counterpart. For Oduanyo Adekoye now, is to make athletes such as Mercy Genesis. We discovered a young talent in Sumisola Balogun. She has qualified for the Youth Olympics. Toby, when we do this sort of competition, most times it's not just to win, it's to discover talent.
Yeah, I mean, Odoya has been very, very consistent. You need to give it to her. I mean, you know, a lot of competition. You know, she has been consistent. She's won several times. You know, started, you know, as a young lady, and she has really grown. And I mean, she has been an inspiration to other athletes, you know, behind her. We've seen a couple of, you know, athletes really learning from her, really hoping and challenging her. You know, the more we have more competition, you know, the more we'll grow up, you know, have a lot of talent. I mean, really, really kudos to Odoyo. He has been really consistent, and I'm really excited that we now have platform to discover 1 or 2, 3 athletes, you know, which might also step into the show if Adekoye, you know, becomes an agent, because, you know, we need more athletes, we need more competition, we need more people that can represent Nigeria on the world. You know, if Adekoye is not available, we need equal quality that can offer what Adekoye will give us. And really excited about the discovery, you know, from the Port Harcourt event.
That's right. So that says Oduanyo Adekoye right there on the mat. She didn't waste time in seeing of Esombe Emiliane from Cameroon. And just as Toby mentioned, when there is no Oduanyo Adekoye, there is Blessing Oborodudu. Blessing Oborodudu also gave a good showing at this championship to win her 8th African title. Amazing. Winnie Gofit also won a gold medal for Nigeria. She was awesome. Bisola Makonjola also got a gold medal. Aminat Adeni, our quality never in doubt, also won a gold medal for Nigeria. So Nigeria had a fantastic final day with the female wrestlers. They went there and then straight up got 9 gold medals for the country. So we'll continue to review the African Wrestling Championships and see how Nigeria fared and the lessons they need for the Nigerian Wrestling Federation and even River State for hosting such a competition. What are the lessons in terms of hosting and making sure that persons come here and see international standards?